And more than 9 months into the pandemic, COVID-19 is spreading with a vengeance. It has now killed a reported 280,000 Americans, according to Johns Hopkins University. Record numbers of new cases and hospitalizations increase concern that a dark winter is ahead. CBS 4's Michael George reports from New York.
In Southern California, a stay-at-home order goes into effect on Sunday in 11 counties and in 12 counties to the north in the state's San Joaquin Valley after hospital ICU capacity fell below 15%. The order issued by Governor Gavin Newsom will remain in effect for at least 3 weeks. A Los Angeles restaurant owner who was forced to shut down because of coronavirus restrictions is frustrated after a film crew was able to set up outdoor dining for its workers right across from her restaurant.
People wonder why I'm protesting and why I have had enough.
The shutdown includes Los Angeles, San Diego, Stockton, and Modesto, as most of California struggles with another destructive wave of COVID-19. Much of the San Francisco Bay Area is also going under new preemptive restrictions that affect millions of residents and businesses in 5 counties.
People's jobs, their businesses, their livelihoods are at stake. This is going to be painful.
More fallout from the pandemic may come at the end of the year when a temporary federal moratorium on tenant evictions is set to end. In New Orleans, Louisiana, Cordelia Rogers got furloughed from her 2 jobs in the spring.
My finances are very much dwindling. I can't keep paying my rent.
And in New York City, even in a pandemic, the Nutcracker holiday tradition will go on.
Dancers are masked and socially distanced, tested, so we feel like we can pull this off safely.
In Brooklyn, the audience will stand on the sidewalk while the legendary ballet is performed on the other side of the glass. Michael George, CBS News, New York.